to Texas!
He's a 10.
I choose this family.
Hey everyone, welcome to our very first podcast of I Want Lone Star Roundup. We're so excited to start talking about Lone Star with you guys.
I'm your host, Katie, and I'm here with
my lovely co-host.
I'm EJ.
I'm Grace.
And we're so excited to start talking about Lone Star with you guys. But
first, we're going to give a brief introduction to ourselves. I guess I'll go first. I'm Katie, like I said, and I'll give you a few fun facts about myself. I just graduated from the University of SUNY Cortland, majoring in English, and
putting myself out there online is definitely not new to me.
I've been doing YouTube for 5 years, but this is definitely something very
new and fun, especially with my great friends.
I'm EJ. I'm born and raised in Western Washington, and I still live there. I'm an only child, so that kind of always has some odd news. Some people aren't. I love my family, my friends, and I love writing, so I've been doing a lot of that, working on my own novel. It's a little bit about me.
I'm Grace. I'm from Maryland. I'm a comedian. And yeah, that's just about it for me.
I'm Shaz. I'm from New York City. Like most people here, I am an actress. Well, kind of. and I'm a weird history nerd. That's all the fun facts about me.
And I'm from upstate New York, if anyone cares.
Don't know if you do, but
so I guess to start, we'll talk about our favorite ships briefly and our favorite characters, storylines, that kind of stuff.
I mean, so we've all agreed that Tarlos is our like favorite ship, and then I don't know, I don't like disconnecting TK and Carlos because they're, like, as far as I'm concerned, the same person now. So,
yes,
outside of those two people, agreed. Who are your favorites? Because I know I like Grace.
Yeah, I do too.
Yeah. Marjan.
Yeah, Marjan too.
It's hard.
Paul and Marjan are, like, tied for me.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, because I love those two.
Like, this is the first show that I've ever watched where I like all the characters. There's not really a character besides like the minor ones that just come in that I don't like. I like all, I pretty much like them all. I mean, I like them all on different levels, but it's definitely, I like them all in general.
Yeah, that's close to the same for me too. Just, it's hard not to like any of the main characters, in my opinion. And there are the small ones going through that, you know, they don't matter. But other than that,
should we go on to questions?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So the first question we got is,
what got us into the show and how we started watching?
So I started Star while I watched 911.
So it obviously made sense that I started watching Lone Star, and I saw promos and I was like, okay, this looks really good. And in the promos, I saw that Rob Lowe was going to be in it, and I was like, okay, I have to watch this. Like, it's gonna be so good.
And I remember watching the first two episodes. I think I watched Tuesday after they released. Like, they released them, like, small in one day.
And in the first episode, I was hooked.
And that's basically how I started watching. I haven't stopped.
I also started watching 911 first. I watched it actually for, like, a year, maybe two, before I got into Lone Star. Quarantine had me watching it over and over again. Yes. And eventually I got bored of it. And I'm like, okay, there's this spinoff. I have no idea what it's going to be like, but let's see. I started watching. I've only liked one show faster than I liked Lone Star, and that was because I got hooked on it from the intro. But, like, it was so fast that, like, it drew me in. And, yeah, never looked back.
Yeah, I think for me, I've always been into medical and, like, first responder dramas. Yes. So, like, 911 in general is just, you know, like, that whole, like, storyline and everything. So I started watching that when it first came out a couple years ago. I'd moved a little bit, so I didn't have a way to watch the second season. But then I saw previews for Lone Star and I think the tsunami episode prior to that. So I caught up with season two and what was on Hulu of season three of 911 just around the time that Lone Star started. And I'm like, okay, I'll give it a try because, you know, sometimes spinoffs aren't successful.
Mm-hmm.
But mm-hmm. other times they can be. So I started watching Lone Star and I had seen that Rob Lowe was going to be in it, which I was like, okay, I'm going to watch it for Rob Lowe. And I, like you guys were saying earlier, like, there's not a character, main character on the series that I don't like, or, like, I don't dislike. I think every character has great storylines and great, like, elements to their characters, which makes it just a really awesome cast. And I love that the cast is so interactive with people.
Yeah.
Like, Ronan and Rafa. And
oh my gosh, yes.
Yeah.
Natasha, Brian, Jules. I mean, they're all awesome just being on Instagram and chatting. Responding, sharing our stories. Those are always fun.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so it's just been really cool to get in. So I've been watching the series since the beginning, but I actually didn't get into the fandom, like connecting with fans online, until after the first season ended. I was like, well, now the season's over. Who am I going to talk to about this?
Same.
So I was like, I'm going to start following all these like fan blogs. And I was like, oh, okay. Yeah, so that's kind of how I got into it.
I got into Lone Star from... after I saw like gift sets of Tarlos on Tumblr. I started reading fan fictions first, actually. Like, my friend, she just like sent me all these links, and I would read them. I'm like, who the hell are these people? She's like, you gotta watch the show. And I did. And then I remember one time I was like watching it on my phone at work. This was around when I was working on the JFK, and it was like shutting down, so there was not like a lot of people. And one time I was like just watching it on my phone, and I like left pizza in the oven and just like burned.
Why did I suddenly get a flashback to the intro of the first episode?
I was like, holy shit, I remember this. Like, my pizza was like burnt in the oven.
Like, crap. Love that. So the next one is, how do you guys feel about TK's mom and Tommy Vega? I guess I'll go first again. Okay, so I feel like since the news first came out, my opinion has changed just naturally. For at first, I was thinking that, like, maybe she'd be, like, not, like, I never thought she would be, like, homophobic, but I thought maybe, I definitely still think the relationship's gonna be a lot different than Owen and TK's, but I definitely think maybe, I think she will, she is probably still, like, it's not like she's a terrible person or whatever, but I am very curious about, like, why, because we really don't know anything about her. They could have a close relationship, they could not, but I don't think it's as close as Owen and TK, so my opinions are definitely all over the place for that. But I don't know, it's hard to say. I definitely, we haven't seen even just a snippet of her. They're probably gonna leave that for, they might not even show that, it's hard to say, but I think the relationship that way will definitely be very different, but I'm curious of how different it would be. I kind of have feeling that maybe TK is a teenager, maybe he said that that Owen left him when after 9/11, so I'm kind of curious if when he grew up, the mom started like picking up with work, maybe she was at home more when he was a kid, and maybe when he was a teenager, and maybe that led to his drug addiction and that kind of stuff. But that's how I feel on her. And then Tommy Vega, when it was first announced, I was excited because new character, and her storyline is very interesting. I think she has a lot to bring, and with the recent promo we got, just a little snippet, I think she'll really fit in, and I'm excited for that storyline.
Go on.
No, go ahead, Grace.
I was just thinking, TK's mom, I think there are a lot of different expectations of her. Like, some people are expecting her to be homophobic and this awful person, and some people are expecting, I don't even know, like, there's so many different versions. Yeah. And by this point, I'm kind of not forming an opinion. Like, I think that she likes, I think she loves her son. I've gotten no indication from the show that they're anywhere near as close as, like, he and Owen, because I don't think TK's ever even mentioned her. If I remember correctly, both mentions were Owen's.
Yeah, the flashback.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I think from that, though, we could kind of see that she does care for her son a lot. When he was, like, talking or whatever, that she cares for his well-being. Like, because she's a lawyer, you know, those things, you know, that kind of job takes up a lot of time.
Yeah. So, you know, I'm excited to see what they do with it. I think they'll execute it really well. And I'm interested to see, like, what the tensions are going to be like, what rhythms there are going to be, especially between her and Owen. And I'm hoping we'll get a, like, more of a look into TK's childhood through her coming. But yeah, that's basically how I feel about Gwen. Honestly, Tommy Vega, I don't have an opinion about her.
Same.
Yeah. I think my only hope is that I don't know how to say this without being like sounding weird, but I hope she doesn't take over like her storyline. Yeah. I hope it doesn't offset everything else. I hope she doesn't kind of shove Michelle out of the story. Like, I'm not someone who likes change very much. So we will, I think we can only see, but anyway, that's it for me.
Yeah, I think, well, you know, definitely. So for those who don't know, Gwyneth Strand is the name of TK's mom. And I think Gwen is definitely going to be an interesting character because we see the dynamic that TK and Owen have. And it's obviously going to be a completely different relationship with TK and his mom. It sounds like from what Owen said towards the end of the season about his mom being a business lawyer, or she was traveling abroad. So it makes me think she's some sort of like international business lawyer. I mean, why else would you be a lawyer and go to China
for? Yeah, and the fact she was in China, like, literally, well, no, lockdown started like a week after that, but like I left school, like, yeah. We got notice like literally 2 days after this episode, we had to get out.
Yeah, exactly. So I think it's definitely going to be interesting to see what like emotions that brings up in TK. And yeah. I'm curious, like, how much time has lapsed between the end of season one and where season two picks up, because we know she was coming to visit TK because of him getting hurt. But we, like, I don't imagine TK is going to be off work more than like a couple of weeks after the end of that season one. So doesn't sound like there's going to be a lot of
time. I heard there wasn't going to be a time jump between the finale and episode one.
Oh, okay.
So I think what will happen is season two will probably pick up right where they left off, or like I said, no time jump, but they could literally just go a few days without being a time jump. Yeah. So I think maybe they'll like have his mom come in, and then like they'll do that. And then maybe, like, episode two or possibly three will jump a little bit. Because I know we're supposed to, like, plus 9-1's supposed to be 6 months in advance, I think, or something like that. Some time jump. So it would only make sense that they were on the same schedule eventually.
Yeah.
Maybe not the first episode.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Because they also have confirmed a crossover. Yeah. So they're going to have to intersect time at some point. So yeah, unless they do, like, a couple time jumps in one of the series, I'm gonna bet they're gonna be on the same page.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, it kind of have to be.
Yes.
Same!
Yeah, you know, Tommy Vega, too, is definitely gonna throw... It's definitely gonna be interesting. Like, Grace, you're saying you don't like change. I'm not a big change person.
Mm-hmm.
But I think... Okay. Here's how I will say this. Tommy's gonna be taking over for Michelle. Michelle's leaving. We don't know how and why. Because we know that Liv Tyler's not coming back this season, which I totally respect her decision to not do that.
Oh, most definitely.
She's taking care of her family.
Yeah.
And it's just too much of a stressor. And like when I first found that out, I didn't realize she was living in London. Like that was her home base.
Yeah.
So like it's cool. And like I know Raphael has said that, you know, he's, as far as he's concerned, he's just like Michelle's in the back of his mind as if, you know, she's still there, just not on screen. And I think we're all going to just like keep that because we don't know how long Tommy Vega's going to be there. You know, she's a mom. She might decide, you know, it's not going to last and she'll only be there a season. But I'm curious to see how they're going to take the whole COVID situation. And I guess her husband lost his business, or the business started to go under because of COVID. So
wasn't he a restaurant owner?
Yes, that's it. So it's curious to see like what they're going to take it. It's definitely open to a lot of, you know, plans, and she seems like she's going to work well with the rest of the crew. So hopefully it'll continue. And yeah, I'm really excited for the crossover. I was actually just thinking when you guys were talking about it, I was like, what if the crossover ends up just being a, like, in a flashback or a memory sequence? Like, it doesn't necessarily have to be current
events.
That's
true.
I hope it does, but that makes sense.
Yeah.
I'm actually going to hop in on the Tommy Vega just because I was thinking about it. I think my one of my main apprehensions with her is, what are they going to do after season two? Like, after... We have no idea what's going to happen with COVID. We have no idea what's happening with all of that. So we don't know when Liv's even going to be back.
Yeah. Right.
But when Michelle does come back, what are they going to do with Tommy? I mean, they cannot have two paramedic captains. Yeah. Not unless they had two separate teams, which they don't. So do they just go, okay, you served your purpose. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Yeah, that's how I felt when she was first announced.
But I thought she was, like, announced before Liv decided that she was going to make this act for season two.
But they had been talking about this for months, apparently. So.
Oh, okay. So that makes sense.
Yes.
Because I was worried, like, I thought they were originally going to have two COVID, paramedic captains.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just weird to think that they would have two at a time. I don't know. Well, if they had, like, two ambulances, it would make more sense, because then, like...
Yeah, they had two teams.
It's already three people on one ambulance in season one, so I can't...
Which, in the world, that's pretty common. Actually, have an EMT, a paramedic, and possibly a second paramedic.
Yeah, definitely.
So, but to have a fourth is slim. Unless they did, like, opposite shifts.
Yeah, that makes sense. That would make a lot more sense.
Because usually, like, fire departments have two to three shifts. Like, they'll have A, B, and C shift.
Yeah, they do. But the thing with that is, if they put her on a different shift, then she might as well not even be there. Because they're not going to show the other shift. Not unless they want to bring an entirely different... Basically make an entirely different show.
Oh, I don't think
they do that. Yeah, no. One spinoff.
Yeah.
I don't think...
So our third question says, what do you think will happen with TK's mom and now being in the show since we've only seen TK and on? I feel like we all kind of talked about that a little bit.
Yeah, I think we all touched
on
it.
But I guess we can briefly talk about it again if anybody has anything to add. Like I said before, I definitely think the relationship between TK and his mom is definitely different than Owen and TK. A father-son relationship and then a mother-son relationship is very different, so I just thought about that, actually.
Plus, they work together and live together, so they definitely are closer than Owen and, I'm sorry, TK and his mom.
Yeah, and it doesn't mean he doesn't love her, even if their relationship isn't, like, as close, but it's definitely different, and I'm open. I'm not really thinking too much about, like, what the relationship is. I definitely think there might be some tension there, but definitely not anything too major.
Well, speaking as the daughter of divorced parents, I think I'm going to be interested to see. Sometimes parents can basically shame the other to their child during a separation, and I doubt that's really what happened.
Right.
But since TK, like, we can tell he lived with his mom for some point in time, but now he's, like, super close with his dad, even if there is, like, a little bit lingering, resentment, is that the right word, about what happened? I think a lot rides on how Owen and Gwen are. Like, are they merely getting along for the sake of their son? Do they have a somewhat friendly relationship? Like, what's going on there?
It also brings up this point, like, how did TK and Owen, like, reconnect? Because we know Owen was, like, for work a lot. So I want to know, like, at what point in TK's life did they reconnect? Because they do seem to have, like, a deep bond. And, like, Owen is well aware of, like, his drug problems and so on. So I just want to know, like, was it during his phase of, like, you know, drug issues that they reconnected? Or was, like, before or after? I'm very interested to see how that shift happened in their relationship.
You know, from all the feelings I've gotten from what Owen and TK said, it sounds like, how do I phrase this? Like, Owen may have found TK the first overdose, or found out his drug problem or something. He didn't seem like he'd, like, learned about it from somebody else. He seemed very, he had been in that time.
Yeah, that's what I thought too, but I'm like, were they close before it happened, or did they, like, rebuild a relationship after?
Yeah, we also don't know when the drug problem started, or when this first big problem was. Like, was he in college? Was he in high school? Like, was he even in the fire department yet? Which I'm guessing he must have been in either high school or college, but because, you know, crazy stuff happens in college. But we don't know.
Well, yeah, and I think, you know, it's gonna be curious, because, like, I watched the first episode last night, and I was when Owen was talking to him in New York, he's like, you know, were you trying to kill yourself? Were you, you know, what was going on? And he's like, and TK said, I haven't touched anything for years. So it made me, I'm like, okay, so like you, I think the high school situation, because I know when I was in high school, a lot of the, there were some kids that, you know, did some stuff they shouldn't have been doing.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, and so it's very easy. And like you said, you know, at the time that TK would be growing up, there's an opioid epidemic, unfortunately, in this, you know, in the world. And that's unfortunately easy to come by. I know, I'm not going to talk too much about other series, but I did watch the first few seasons of Chicago Fire, and they had a character on there who was basically getting his paramedic friend to give him pain medication so he could shoot himself up.
I was there long enough to set,
you know,
when
they sever, you know, and so that, like, that whole first season, you know, because that came from an injury. You know, he'd gotten injured, he got addicted to the medication.
I mean, painkiller addictions are, like, probably the most common like way of getting addicted, and that may have even been what started TK. Like, maybe he got injured in high school or college and he was on painkillers and he just couldn't stop. That would be fully, like, conceivable.
Something similar happened in Station 19 as well.
Last season. So that perfectly leads us to our next question, which is, what other shows do you guys watch or keep watching lately? It's really hard.
Question. Yeah,
a bunch of different shows, but
They asked.
Honestly, okay. So I'm trying to think of what I'm watching currently. I'm watching Station 19 and Grey's Anatomy.
Me too.
I don't know. I've watched it for years, so it's kind of like the point where I can't stop. I'm trying to think, what else have I watched? I don't know. I watch like random things on Netflix sometimes, so I don't know. Consistently, I feel like I watch those.
Yeah, I know for me, like, I used to watch so much TV. Like, I'd have, like, six shows, like, a night I'd watch because I was keeping up with everything. But I've really cut back on what I watch. The 911 and 911's Lone Star I'm definitely keeping up on now. And I'm a huge fan of, like, the original Roswell. So, from the one from 1999. So, I'm really into that and the fandom. Shout out to all my fellow Roswellians out there. And our Dans for Baron and Saluka. You know, I'm not really watching that much other scripted television. I am watching, like, The Curse of Oak Island on the History Channel because I just kind of love that mystery, like, treasure hunting kind of thing. And other shows. The Night Shift was a really awesome short TV show. Yes, I love it. Brendan Fair was awesome in that. And I love Luke McFarlane in there, too. That should not have ended. I'm bitter about that. That's a whole other topic to talk about later. so those are a few of the shows I'm keeping up on.
I thought about that one recently because it takes place in Texas, too, and it takes place in San Antonio, which it's not, I don't forget what the actual mileage is to, like, Austin, but I don't remember it being too far.
Yeah, it's only like
so I've always thought about that.
Well, my big one, like the one I've been binge watching to reward myself for school or procrastinate doing school, like either, is Criminal Minds. I'm on the 11th season out of like 13, I think. So that's a big one. I have a very varied taste in shows. So I was also watching The Good Place, a Great British Baking Show. I told you it's varied. I've loved old TV shows since I was younger, so currently I'm watching MASH.
I love MASH.
MASH is amazing. Actually, an old TV show, this is going to be a little off topic, so stick with me. Actually, kind of on topic. More on topic than this. But I grew
up... Emergency?
Yes! That is how... I grew up watching old TV shows, and Emergency was the first... emergency show I've ever watched. I love that show so much. It owns a place in my heart. Like, oh my gosh,
that was my mom's favorite show when I was growing up. She'd always watch it whenever I'd see her watching it whenever she could find it on TV.
Yes, I own three of the seasons, and I'm trying to get the other ones because, you know, with older TV shows, you don't know how long there are going to be copies out there.
That's true. Yeah.
So yeah, working on that. So Emergency, that's a favorite. what else? I have other shows lined up that I'm going to watch, like Schitt's Creek, for example.
Oh, yes. I knew I forgot one. That was it.
Yes.
I love that series.
Like, I've heard so many good things about it, and I'm so excited to watch it. But other than that, like, 911, 911 Lone Star, that's basically my show watching right now. I'm going to let someone else talk.
Station 19 is back. I guess most of my watching will be for that until like 911 and Lone Star comes back. But I've also been watching, don't hate me for this, but the Jersey Shore. Yeah, that shit is so stupid. I love it so much. Like the mind.
Never seen it, but I've heard stuff about it.
These people are like so entertaining. And Ghost Adventures. I love Ghost Adventures. I could like binge watch it at midnight. It's my favorite time to watch it. Yeah, that's all. That's all. Because I just finished Schitt's Creek like last week. It was awesome. I cried. Mm-hmm. I definitely cried.
It's good. It's cute. I cried.
And I cry for everything. So yeah, that's all. Mm-hmm.
Have tissues ready.
I've been in scenarios where everyone around me is crying for some reason, and I'm like, why are we crying? Did I miss something? Like, what's happening? Or I'll be.
I hardly cry.
For no apparent reason.
I never cry for shows. Yeah.
I don't cry much, but...
I've only cried a few times for TV shows. I cried in Station 19 once or twice. I think I cried in Lone Star a handful of times.
I cried a lot in Lone Star.
And then I cried when I was kid watching a show.
Yeah, the cancer storyline gets me every time.
Yeah, I cry a lot. Like, when Owen is, like, standing by the memorial, the 9/11 memorial. That shit makes me cry all the time.
Oh my gosh, yes! Gosh. Oh my gosh.
My cousin, she has a brother-in-law that's on the memorial. He was a firefighter, I believe, and passed away in
9/11. I wasn't even here for 9/11, but, like, every time I go to the memorial, it makes me, like, oh my god, I'm gonna cry right now.
Yeah.
Honestly, yes, I as you guys know, and now our listeners will know, my goal and dream is to be a firefighter. And this is something I've wanted ever since I was a little kid. And I always played more with, like, fire trucks than I did with dolls. Like, it's been a thing for my entire life. And I remember at some points I've been reading, like, documentaries about, like, famous fires. And I know 9/11 was on there. And honestly, just reading the stories and... like, something like 443 firefighters died that day. Or wait, 343, it was 440 something that, like, first responders that died that day. I got my numbers mixed up. And just thinking about all that, and it's very easy for me to put myself in, like, those shoes. Yeah. Because, you know, guess what profession I'm going into? It hits another way because, you know, I may not be in that profession currently, but I regard myself as that family. So, you know, it's like, these are brothers and sisters that were killed in their work. And firefighters have a very small chance of dying, actually. So, you know, just thinking about it.
Okay, so we only have one more question, and that is, will we ever interview fans on the podcast? I think
we have to find our footing with each other first before we move forward with other people.
Definitely.
Yeah, get more established, put out a bunch of episodes, and then figure out, like, what we're doing with that, but I think it's a possibility.
More likely,
I definitely think it's something we could do in the future, you know. Yeah.
Yeah. Or, like,
the break, I think it would definitely be interesting to talk to other people and ask them, like, how you got in the show, this and that. And I definitely think it'd be fun to talk with other people, but definitely more down the line. I think we're very open to it. But yeah, just not right now. We talk in general on a normal basis, so it's not like we're uncomfortable with each other, but definitely we're still getting the hang of this kind of thing. So yeah, so definitely down the line is basically the triple bond answer.
Thanks everybody for the questions. You gave us questions to answer. Yes,
thank you so much. Yes. And we'll definitely do a kind of question and answer thing maybe in an episode in the future. Yeah.
Yeah, this was
so
fun.
Now I guess we can talk about our plans.
Yeah, so I guess it's just right now we're just kind of like, you know, we kind of talked about finding our footing, and I know we want to talk a little bit. We're not going to do reviews on, like, each episode, but we're definitely going to, like, talk about elements that really stood out to us.
Yeah.
So we're not going to, like, go through, like, scene by scene, like, talking about every scene, but I think it'd be fun to, you know, just... because each one of us is all, like, we're all different. We all come from different backgrounds, so it's going to be cool to see, like, what we see differently and what we see the same in those episodes.
Yeah. Like, you guys already know what happens in the episode, but what we're going to be saying is our perspective, what stood out to us, what it meant to us, that kind of thing.
So we definitely won't be recapping everything like we said, but we will, like, say, like, give context of what happens, just to be like yeah, this is what we're talking about, but we'll definitely give a new take on it, rather, because there's thousands of recaps you can read online if you're really that curious.
And we'll have more and more to talk about and express, and even maybe recap to some degree when the new definitely. Season comes
I think
out.
That'll be more fresh, so it'll be different for us.
But this is a season.
Everyone's seen it. Everyone's rewatched it 10 times, right. Maybe more.
True.
Yeah.
And if they haven't, then they can, like, definitely. It's easy enough.
So we'll be dropping episodes every single Monday.
Then we might change. When we do it, we'll definitely be doing at least one episode a week for here on out, I guess.
Yeah. Sounds good.
So excited.
We just want to thank everybody for tuning in, and hopefully you'll join us for our next podcast. Sounds like we'll have one out next Monday. And, you know, you can catch the 911 Lone Star Roundup podcast at 911LS Roundup on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. I'm EJ, and you can find me at EJ8302.
I'm Katie, and you can follow me on Instagram at For the Love of Tarlos and Twitter at For Love of Tarlos, because Twitter's annoying and you can't have a long username, so that's fun.
I'm Grace, and you can find me on Instagram at RoninRathlin911, and you can find me on Twitter at CheapGirl31.
Okay, I'm Shaz, and you can find me on Tumblr, Twitter, and Instagram at Buttercup Strand.
Again, thank you so much for listening, and we'll see you next week.
Bye.